This woman wants the biggest hips in the world, and it's safe to say she may just succeed. This is 43-year-old Bobby Jo Wesley from Pennsylvania. She's 5'2" and weighs 542 pounds, and her hips are an astonishing 95 inches wide. Doctors have warned her that she needs to lose weight, but she's on a mission to have the world's biggest hips, and no one is going to stop her. She is scared about dying, but she says her unhealthy pursuit is just something that she has to do, and she's taking it one day at a time. She wants to be remembered for something, and thinks that having the world's biggest hips is what she's meant to be remembered for. Her large size does stop her from doing a number of basic everyday things, and she will even get out of breath from just walking across the room. In order to achieve her goal, she will need to get her hips to 99 inches. So right now she's 4 inches away. Michaela Raffinelli is the person who currently holds the record, and she's held on to it since 2013. Bobby Jo lives with her husband, and she's noticed over the years that there are men out there who really like her shape, so much so that she has a growing online following, and she will post her men via webcam. From this she can earn around $2,000 per hour. Not only does she get money, but she also sometimes gets presents and letters from her fans. She's even gotten a marriage proposal or two. Obviously with the good comes the bad, and there are trolls out there, but she just ignores the negativity. She says, "When I get people on social media who say I'm fat, I really don't react to it because I am fat." Bobby Jo says that the reason she's had massive weight gain over the years is because of an underactive thyroid, which was diagnosed when she was just age 6. A nutritionist went to visit her at her home recently and said that she needs to start eating healthier or she could die. It's literally a life or death choice at this point, but Bobby Jo is not giving up on her dream. Hello everyone, and welcome back to LP. I'm Court McGinley. Thank you for joining me on this beautiful Friday. And this Friday is extra beautiful, as today is the day Landon is getting married. So exciting. Two of my best friends are getting married. What's better than that? It's going to be amazing. Make sure you follow me on Instagram at Court McGinley, and Landon as well, because we will be posting some behind the scene footage for you guys. And make sure you comment down below congratulating Landon so he can see all of your wonderful comments. Alright, as always, we have a bunch of interesting news stories headed your way, so without further ado, let's get started. Next, there's talk that Albus Dumbledore might be openly gay in Fantastic Beasts 2. As you HP fans might remember, back in 2007, while on a book tour for the final film, the Harry Potter saga, The Deathly Hallows, author J.K. Rowling, who is also writing the Fantastic Beasts film, revealed that the Hogwarts head teacher Albus Dumbledore is gay, despite not giving any indication of this in the books or movies. While the audience was happy to hear about this layer of diversity, many of the fans were also disappointed that Rowling had never hinted at Dumbledore's sexuality in her books. About the young Dumbledore, Rowling said, "You will see Dumbledore as a young man and quite troubled. He wasn't always sage. We will see him at the formative period in his life. As far as his sexuality is concerned, watch this space." So a lot of people are saying that this statement kind of implies that Dumbledore would indeed be played as openly gay in the upcoming film. This year, other huge movies took the risk and had openly gay characters. Take Beauty and the Beast, for example. It's a PG movie that's aimed at kids, and it's currently the highest grossing movie of the year so far, and it's the 10th highest grossing film of all time. But I guess we'll have to wait and see. Speaking of Dumbledore, there's a Harry Potter themed supper club that's opening in London this summer. This will be located at the Convent Garden Members Club, the library. It'll run from August 4th to September 30th every Friday and Saturday night, and it costs $84. And it's a 7-course menu. This evening will begin with a meeting at the library's own platform 9¾, and you can have a drink of butterbeer or fire whiskey. Then you sit down to dinner. And of course, it wouldn't be a Harry Potter themed dinner without the right costume. So it's requested that everyone dress in the colors of their favorite house. Next, Selena Gomez earns an insane amount of money for an Instagram post. Seriously, you're not gonna believe this. She charges companies up to $550,000 just to post a picture with some of their products to her Instagram page. But she is the most followed person on Instagram with 123 million followers, so clearly companies want to have her endorsing their products. It's a smart business move. For example, her most liked picture is for a Coca-Cola ad, which has 6.7 million likes. So clearly, the girl knows what she's doing. And it's that time of the week where I'll let you know what super cool, awesome movies are hitting box office this weekend. And we have Spider-Man Homecoming and The Big Sick. Let's start off with Spider-Man Homecoming. This movie's rated PG and it's an action-adventure movie. In this movie, we have Tom Holland, Michael Keaton, Robert Downey Jr., Marissa Tomei, Gwyneth Paltrow, and Zendaya Coleman, among others. And fun fact, John Watts was the director and co-producer on this film. In this movie, young Peter Parker, who makes his sensational debut in Captain America Civil War, as he begins to navigate his newfound identity as the web-slinging superhero. Thrilled by his experience with the Avenger, Peter returns home where he lives with Aunt May, under the watchful eye of his new mentor, Tony Stark. Peter tries to fall back into his normal daily routine, distracted by thoughts of proving himself to be more than just your friendly neighborhood Spider-Man. But when the Vulture emerges as a new villain, everything that Peter holds most important will be threatened. Check it out.
Our friends are up there! What are you hiding, Peter?
Next, we have The Big Sick. This movie is rated 14A and it's a comedy romance. This movie has an intimate cast including Zoe Kazan, Kumail Nanjiani, Holly Hunter, and Ray Romano, among others. This movie is based off the real-life courtship. Pakistan-born comedian Kumail and a grad student Emily fall in love, but they struggle as their cultures clash. When Emily contracts a mysterious illness, Kumail must navigate the crisis with her parents, and an emotional tug-of-war begins between his family and his heart. Well, there you have it. That's all the news stories I have for you guys today. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't yet, and I'll catch you in the next one.